What's up, Vinyl Community? It's your boy Chris coming at you live, as always, from the Man Cave. Glorious late Saturday night after 11 o'clock East Coast time, when I get to do my damage, when I get to do my dirt in here in the Man Cave, if you will. Pretty tired as always, but it doesn't matter. I'm up. And first things first, ice cold IPA. Courtesy of Amor Ortiz Brewing in Fort Mill, South Carolina. Cruising down the street, my six folk. You hip-hop fans, clearly get it. Clearly get the reference. One of my favorite beers. I love it. Anyway, on this night. So, ever since the release of Thelonious Monk's Palo Alto on Impulse Records was announced, I have been flat out giddy. New Monk music? Are you kidding? I've been on board ever since I heard about it. So, it was announced, then it was delayed, lawsuits tied it up, yada, yada, yada. I got skeptical. I was like, oh, Lord, who knows? Then finally got a confirmation, it's coming. Like, this is the date. It will be shipped this date. And I'm like, yes. And I've been looking forward to it ever since. So, it shows up in my mailbox today. I've been looking at it all day, in the plastic, the whole nine. Wanting to spin it, wanting to at least open it and look at the inserts, I decided, nah, I need to share this moment, this entire thing with my viewers, with you guys, with my YouTube subscribers. So, I'm looking at it now and I just can't wait. In 1968, Palo Alto High School student by the name of Michael Scher, I believe I'm pronouncing it right, I believe I'm pronouncing it correctly, who's in charge of, you know, putting on the concerts and whatever at the school, which, by the way, the amount of talent they were able to get there, it's like, man, I went to a school with 300 kids. I graduated with a class of 43. Anyway, Thelonious Monk? What? What? Anyway, but evidently, he had somehow, some way managed to convince Thelonious Monk to perform at Palo Alto High School in California, obviously. And, man. And the janitor at the school, evidently, had requested that he be allowed to record the concert in exchange for tuning the piano, which, of course, was agreed upon. So he recorded the concert, and it sat recorded. In a box, evidently, for like 50 years before somebody was like, hey, what do you guys think about recording this and releasing this? And Thelonious Monk's son, T.S. Monk, was contacted and was like, hey, what do you think about, you know, us releasing this? And that set this in motion. And it's just, before you even get to the concert itself, it's a great backstory. If you think about what's going on in our country in 1968, by the time 1968 rolls around, I mean, you've had John F. Kennedy and Robert Kennedy have both been assassinated. Martin Luther King has been assassinated. Malcolm X has been assassinated. A slew of others. I mean, that's what's going on in our country at the time. And so it's a great day of divide. You would think, you know, the great Thelonious Monk, Palo Alto High School in California, that's going to be, anybody, feel free to correct me if I'm wrong, but that's, you got to think that's almost exclusively white high school. Damn near. And to get the great Thelonious Monk, who granted at 51 years of age in 1968, was definitely on the back end of his, you know, his relevancy, if you will. Still, that's an all-time great jazz icon performing at your high school. And it's the only time he and his band ever did so. And thanks to this janitor and Michael Scher, we have it now available to us for the very first time on release. You can hear it on CD if you want, stream if you want. Me, you guys know how I wagon wheel. I'm going vinyl. So here it is sitting next to me. I've been staring at it all day, like I said. I'm getting ready to go through the opening experience with you guys. And then, hey, why not listen to it right after? Thelonious Monk, Palo Alto, on Impulse. Unknown, unheard, until now. Thelonious Monk, 1968. Gotta tell you guys, I'm giddy, just holding it. Been looking forward to it. Monk, my favorite jazz pianist of all time. My favorite, yeah, top two or three favorite jazz artists of all time. I just... What else can you say about genius, really? I mean... Trying my best to... There you go. I gotta get this plastic cut off the best I can without doing any damage to the cover or anything like that. So now that garbage is off, trash, automatically I'm impressed with it because you got that traditional Impulse spine, love. Got that very authentic looking Impulse cover. Got that Impulse gatefold. Beautiful. Which automatically, if you think back to like last year's John Coltrane Blue World, which, by the way, the music was great. The music was great on Blue World, but the presentation, no gatefold, no traditional Impulse cover or whatever. It's just the presentation was just lacking. And the label definitely caught flack for it, justifiably so. And you could tell that they must have been listening because this is, yeah, definitely, automatically. That's before I even dive inside the sleeve. Before I even go inside the gatefold, I know automatically. They were listening. They paid attention. So a nice booklet. Palo Alto. Monk. Cool stuff. A little backstory, if you will. A little more off of what I just told you guys about kind of the backstory of the album, the backstory of the performance. You see the great Thelonious Monk. So I'd love nothing more than just to read this entire thing to you guys, but no reason to do all that. Let you guys experience it for yourself. Hopefully you just go buy it. It's a duplicate, if you will, of the program from the concert. Monk's picture on the front. Get the lineup in here. It's just all of it's great stuff. A complete duplicate, evidently. It's great stuff. And then, of course, here's the program and the program poster. Which, shit, don't put it past me to have that framed. Palo Alto High School Benefit Jazz Concert, Thelonious Monk Quartet, Jimmy Marks Afro Ensemble, featuring Eddie Bow, Electric Flute, 2 p.m. Sunday, October 27th, 1968. Probably High Auditorium. Tickets, $2. $2. $2 to see a jazz musician, a mortal. $2. Wow. So the inserts, automatically. Man, I love every single one of these. I'm safely back in the sleeve in the order I got them. Finally, we're going to get to the goods. Inner sleeve, of course. Great stuff. And then got that wonderful Impulse orange and black label. Guys, I got to tell you, I'm beyond excited for this. What's going to happen here is I realized it was a Before we go in, I think it needs to be as high as I've got my expectations. I think it needs to be understood that this is a recording done by a janitor in 1968 that sat in private possession or whatever or what have you for 50 years before being released. So obviously it's not going to be your most oh my god out of this world audio file recording ever. That being said, I'm just really, really excited to hear some unreleased Thelonious Monk. So I'm about to throw that on. Gonna give you guys some snippets, some tidbits, and then I'm gonna give my final thoughts. Talk to you soon. We'll be right back. Gentlemen, so I just, ladies and gentlemen, so I just finished the LP, and I gotta tell you, I loved it. Is it, if you go into it expecting, you know, supreme, top-notch, top-of-the-line audiophile quality in terms of the sound, you're gonna be disappointed, obviously. I mean, this is a janitor that recorded this album 52 years ago. So, you know, no top-notch, you know, recording equipment or whatever, you know, were used to record it, and for all things considered, it still came out pretty damn good, as I hope you guys were able to make out through the audio samples, which were track one, side A, Ruby My Dear, and track one, side B, Don't Blame Me. The entire album is great. I would highly recommend it. Under $30 for unreleased Thelonious Monk. I would definitely say go get it. It'll definitely be on my turntable for the foreseeable future. It's definitely going on again more often, more frequently, and I'd highly recommend it to anybody, especially if you're a fan of Thelonious Monk or jazz music or Impulse or just, you know, hell, what an incredible backstory and everything for it too. So grab yourself a copy. Thelonious Monk, Palo Alto on Impulse. Again, under $30. Go get it, guys. So, that concludes this video. And until next time, until next video, keep dropping that new to you guys.